Welcome to Java Forum. Now we are going to install Apache Tomcat 8.5 using SapMachine 11 JDK on Windows 10 operating system. So here you can see that I already downloaded Apache Tomcat 8.5 for Windows as a zip file I have downloaded from Apache website. So here you can see that I already installed SapMachine 11 JDK. So SapMachine 11 is a modular JDK and it's a clone of OpenJDK 11 project. So this SapMachine is a product of SAP. So now I am going to set the Java underscore home environment variable pointing to SapMachine 11 because the Java underscore home environment variable is required by Apache Tomcat 8.5. So now let me extract Apache Tomcat 8.5 to one directory. So make sure that you have downloaded the latest version of Apache Tomcat 8.5. So this is the direct structure of Apache Tomcat 8.5. So before I start, I'm going to conf directory. I'm going to open Tomcat users.xml. So in the Tomcat users.xml, uncomment the last 5 lines and assign the roles as shown here, admin guy and manager guy. Make sure that you have a same settings, whatever I did now. Save the Tomcat users.xml. So now I am going to start the Apache Tomcat using that startup.bat. Yes, so Apache Tomcat 8.5 is starting. So unblock SapMachine 11. Unblock the SapMachine 11 from the firewall. So here you can see that Tomcat 8.5 started successfully. Let us verify it is in browser. So this is the Tomcat console. So let me check the server status. So you need to supply the username password which you provided in the Tomcat users.xml. Application manager. Virtual host manager. So everything I can able to view. You can see that SapMachine 11 is detected by Tomcat. So let me try out one example. So I am going to try one WebSocket example. So I'm going to write one text. It's a multiplayer drawing game. So I can able to execute this WebSocket example in Tomcat 8.5 using SapMachine JDK. So I conclude that SapMachine 11 JDK supports Apache Tomcat 8.5. So make sure that you have downloaded the latest version of Apache Tomcat 8.5 which supports Java 11. So I see no errors in the command line.